Hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss a topic on school management vis-a-vis the RTE, that is Right to Education Act 2009. I am Dr. Sanjana Vich, Assistant Professor from Amity Institute of Education, Saket, New Delhi. We will start this topic with the initial thing, that what is school management? What is the role of school management committee? The constitution of school management committee, which is SMC, it is an important provision of the act. Bodies similar to school management committees have long been in the operation in different parts of the country to improve the monitoring and the management of the schools. A school management committee has to be constituted in every school other than unaided school within 6 months of the date of recognition. And the school management committee has to be reconstituted every 2 years. 75% of the strength of the school management committee will have to be from amongst the parents and the guardians of the children. 25% of the strength of the school management committee should be like 1/3 member from the elected members of the local authority to be decided by local authority, 1/3 member from the teachers from the schools to be decided by the teachers of the schools, remaining 1/3 from the local educationist children in the school to be decided by the parents in the committee. Now, we have to discuss the protection of the child right first, then we can further go ahead with each details. So the main important point is that what are the protection of the child right? For example, survival, family, freedom of expression, health and development, protection from abuse and exploitation, equal opportunities and accessing education, dignity and respect, culture and heritage, basic minimum infrastructure like housing, toilets, drinking waters, bright classrooms, books, blackboards, science lab equipments, teachers, entitlement like free education, free uniform, free books, midday meals, quality education, recreation and leisure activities. And at the first level, the primary responsibility to protect children's right rests with the teachers, head teachers, and the school management committee under the Right to Education Act. Preparation of school development plan by school management committee. What could be the preparation of school development plan? Now, this is the responsibility of school management committee. The school management committee will have to prepare a school development plan at least 3 months beforehand. And it should be actually the end of the financial year or before the financial year. The school development plan will be a 3-year plan comprising 3 annual sub-plans. The school development plan shall contains the different type of details, for example, estimates of class-wise enrollment for each year, requirement of the number of additional teachers, including head teachers, subject teachers, and part-time teachers, separating from class 1st to 5th and classes 6th to 8th, calculating according to the form which are available on the net. It should also include the requirement of additional infrastructures and equipments for the 3 years in accordance with the prescribed norms and standards which are thereby prescribed by the RTI. Now, additional year-wise financial requirement for the 3 years, including additional financial requirements for providing special training for teachers, entitlements to children such as free textbooks, uniforms, workbooks, etc. should be clearly mentioned in the development plan. The Right to Education Act mandates that every child must be in school. This presupposes that child labor is eliminated. Inclusive Education and Right to Education Act demands that school management committee maintains vibrant partnerships with the departments and the organizations concerned with the children belonging to scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, and educationally background sessions to ensure entitlements are made available. School management committee needs to work with government departments handling children with disabilities to make sure that equal opportunities should be provided to children with special needs is addressed. School management committee needs to work with rural development and Panchayat Raj Department of the government to accelerate poverty reduction programs so that children are freed from domestic chores and wage earning responsibilities and are able to attend the schools on regular basis. And to ensure that the Panchayat Raj institutions get appropriately involved and discharge their functions under the Right to Education Act. Protection of child rights also includes protection from corporal punishment, abuse, and harassment. There is a need for the school management committee to closely cooperate with the National and State Commission for the Protection of Child Rights and the State Departments of Women and Child Development to ensure that children are protected from abuse. Now, every school other than a school established, owned or controlled by the state government or local authorities established before the commencement of this act shall make a self-declaration within a period of 3 months of the commencement of this act in the form number 1 to the concerned district education officer regarding its compliance with the norms, with the prescribed norms, standards and conditions. The school is run by the society registered under the Societies Registration Act 1860 or a public trust constituted under the law. The school is not run for profit to any individual group or association of individuals or any other persons. The next is the school conforms to the values in the constitutions. The school building or other structures or the grounds are used only for the purposes of education and skill development. The school is open to inspection by any officer authorized by the state government. It could be local authorities. It could be a person from government or from any local authorities. The school has the required infrastructure according to the norms prescribed. The school furnishes such reports and information as may be required by the DEO from time to time and complies with such infrastructure of the state government or the local authorities as may be issued to secure the continued fulfillment of the conditions of recognition or the removal of deficiency in working of the school. Under the Part 4, Section 7, 1, 2, 3 of the Draft Model Rule, for the purpose of getting recognition, a government aided and unaided private school has to admit children belonging to weaker section and disadvantaged group. Failing to do so, they can invite warnings or withdrawal of recognition. And such children shall not be segregated from the other children in the classroom, nor shall their classes be held at places and timings different from the classes held for other children. They shall not be discriminated from the rest of the children in any manner pertaining to entitlements and facilities. For example, I told you textbooks, uniforms, libraries and ICT facilities, extracurriculum, curricular activities and sports. The school is required to appoint qualified trained teachers as prescribed by the NCTE, NCERT and SCERT. Failing to appoint trained teachers may result in derecognition of the school. where a state does not have adequate institutions offering teacher education courses or persons possessing minimum qualifications are not available in sufficient numbers in relation to the requirement of the teachers estimated. The state government will have to request within 1 year of the commencement of the Right to Education Act, the Government of India for relaxation of the prescribed minimum teacher qualifications. The Government of India may relax the minimum qualification by the way of notification specify the nature of relaxation and the time period not exceeding 3 years, but not beyond 5 years from the commencement of Right to Education Act, within which the teachers appoint under the relaxed conditions has to acquire the minimum qualification prescribed by the academic authorities. The person appointed as a teacher within 6 months of the commencement of the Right to Education Act must possess at least the academic qualification not lower than higher secondary school certificate or equivalent. For a teacher who does not possess the minimum qualification at the time of the commencement of Right to Education Act, the management of such school shall enable such teachers to acquire such minimum qualification within a period of 5 years for the commencement of this act. Every school other than the school established, owned or controlled by the state government or by the local authorities, as I have already told you, established before the commencement of this act shall make a self-declaration within a period of 3 months of this commencement of the act in the form number 1 to the concerned district education officer regarding its compliance with the norms, standards and conditions laid down. The UN Development Programme has defined capacity as the ability of the individuals, institutions and the societies to perform functions, solve problems and set and achieve objectives in a sustainable manner. The term capacity building or capacity development describes the task of establishing human and institutional capacity building. Now, information and communication technology, which is ICTs technologies, they are used for communication and for creating, storing, managing, distributing use of information for effective delivery of UEE. The ability of user to communicate, collaborate and exchange information online is especially important for SchoolNet. Now, ICT typically refers to computers, computer networks, internet, telephones, and all together. In ICT, we include televisions, radio, audiovisual equipments, and increasing other devices used as network or internet accesses devices, such as handheld PDAs, which is personal digital assistant, are electronic devices and mobile phones. Those who have easy and affordable access to ICTs and communication networks can participate fully, while those without having fewer opportunities. And it is often assumed that ICT infrastructure and equipments are available in all the schools. The phenomenon of differential access to ICTs is often labeled as digital divide. Three drivers of ICTs uses are language, which is ability to use language that is widely used on the internet. The second is literacy, that is specifically a culture of reading and learning, the level of educational attainment. Education is one of the most important component in creating knowledge, societies, economic growth and prosperity. Education is not only the means by which individual becomes skilled participant in society and economy, it is also one of the key drivers in expanding ICT uses. The development of ICT will build an environment in which most knowledge information is shared and more knowledge is created as the distribution of such information increases. Seen with the context of the transmission to more inclusive UEE and decentralization education system, it is necessary to address structural problems and deficits in the educational systems. Using ICT to enhance administrative and teaching efficiency, to elevate under resources in specific areas, for example, lack of textbooks or teachers and other support materials, to address equity issues or to support teachers who may be under-equipped to deal with new teaching technologies. So today we have learnt the Right of Education Act and decentralization implementation of UEE, why implementation of UEE has been decentralized, who are responsible for preparing education development plans at these levels, what should be the context of educational development plans, what is the appraisal of educational development plans and how it can be approved, and who all are responsible for monitoring the implementation of the plan. What is the government issues that could be including in decentralization management of elementary education? Who is responsible for recognition of private aided or unaided schools? And what is the procedure followed by recognition of school as prescribed by the Right to Education Act? We have also learned today that the child cannot be denied admission to a school. Who is responsible to protect the child's right? You have also learned that how networking using information and communication technologies can be helpful for the better capacity building and managing of elementary education at school block, district, state, and national level. At the last, you have also learned the funding pattern of elementary education. So this is all about today's lecture. Thank you.